What's up, guys? It's Jordan here with NAR Snowboarding. Today we're doing a tech talk about grip tech versus magnet traction. So, let's get into it. Alright y'all, so let's start with grip tech. Who is grip tech made by? Grip tech is made by Arbor. Super sick technology. So basically what grip tech is, it's a trilateral side cut design. Yeah, I don't know what that means either. So basically what it is, it's two additional contact points on the heel side and toe side of the board, which are oriented where your boot lies on the board. So it'll be in front and the back of the inlays for your board, where your bindings sit. What is the purpose behind this? This is basically to give you extra grip where most of your pressure of your board is applied, which, you know, you turn your board and you apply the pressure using your feet. So most of the pressure will be there. So you have that control right there, which gives you better edge to edge. It gives you better stability on long drawn out carves, icy parts. And it also gives you more quick turns when you're getting set up for, let's say, a jib or a jump. So yeah, I mean, it's kind of simple. This additional contact, super sick, super awesome. I have ridden the Arbor Westmark Camber, and it had the grip tech on it. I could definitely feel the difference of grip to the snow way better than a regular board. I don't have any complaints, so yeah. So, magnet traction. That just sounds dope, magnet traction. Anyways, what is magnet traction? Who is it made by? So magnet traction was developed by LipTech. Super sick company. They have, I mean, they're called Lip Technologies. So I mean, you can just imagine how much tech goes into their equipment. That's super sick. Check them out. Anyways, magnet traction adds 7 additional contact points to the heel side and the toe side of your board. Super sick. So I mean, like, what they're saying is for magnet traction is it turns ice into powder. Is this true? We'll get to that. So basically with the 7 contact points, it resembles a serrated type of knife. So basically what it does is it applies more control to the area between your feet where pressure is applied to give you more control on harder pack or icy type of snow. So basically what it does, it maximizes edge pressure between your feet, so that way you have maximum edge control while shredding the gnar. I mean, what more could you want? I have ridden the Gnu Headspace. Gnu is a company from LipTech. That's why they have magnet traction. Anyways, if I'm saying that wrong, let me know. Is it if it's just GNU or is it Gnu? Whatever. Let me know in the comments. Anyways, so I have ridden that board and man, the magnet traction really, really works. It really works. I felt confident on both sides, whether I'm going heel side or toe side, whether it's steep, whether it was hard packed. It was kind of a slushy early season type of conditions, but there was a little bit of hard pack with a little bit of ice, but it gripped right into it. I felt super confident. It was nice. It was nice. Definitely recommend. I also have owned the E-Jack knife by LipTech. Same thing. Super, feel super confident on it. Don't have to worry about slipping out of any carves or anything like that. Anyway, so what would I recommend? Both, either or. I would say the Arbor Grip Tech probably be better and more all mountain, kind of like park type of riding, whereas the Magnet Trash is better with free riding and all mountain type of riding. They do have them in park boards, Magnet Traction. It just seems weird to have those contact points when you're trying to hit a rail. Maybe it could affect you in a way. Maybe it could, you could clip and hit. So that kind of makes me a little nervous. But are there any cons really to these types of technology? Well, you want the honest truth? No. There's no cons. It's just, it's like getting a perk in a game. It just makes it that much more awesomer and more fun. If you can afford to find a board for your riding style and for whatever, however you want it, and you can get Magna Traction or Grip Tech, do it. It is worth it. There are some other companies that do some type of additional contact point boards, but these two are the main ones. But I think it would definitely be worth it if you can find a board by that company that you're interested in for your riding style, for however you want to ride. Do it. Do it now.
Do it now. Go get yourself Grip Tech and Magna Traction.
Anyways, that's it. I hope you guys learned something about them, and I hope you guys get the opportunity to try these type of snowboards, because it is it's next level.
Next level shit.
Anyways, so I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Later.